Hi all, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got Titanic, the Ship, the Legend, issue 10. Excellent stuff. Here we have the parts. We do get the forward keel section, cylinder heads A times 2, cylinder head B and C, distribution valves times 2, exhaust valves times 4 and 6 PM screws. Excellent stuff. There we go. Details for the engine. Brilliant. And coming in issue 11, yes, we have the funnel, funnel wrap, tank filter, funnel cap, and other parts for the first funnel. Let me show you. There we go. Issue 11. Brilliant stuff. So let's have a quick look through the magazine. So the first story on page 3. The band on board Titanic. Aside from Wallace Hartley, little is known about the lives of the other musicians who tried to comfort the passengers on that fateful night. Now there is an interesting part here. This paragraph here. John is associated with an additional bitter memory relating to the attitude of the Black Talent Agency, which did not pay artists particularly well. In 1912, the pay for musicians was £4 a month without reimbursement for the uniform. On 30th of April 1912, the agency sent Hume's father the following telegram. Dear sir, we shall be obliged if you will remit us the sum of 5 shillings and 4 pence, which is owing to us as per enclosed statements. We shall also be obliged if you will settle the enclosed uniform account. This blunt bureaucratic language reflected the contractual rules set out by the agency, but it was an additional source of grief for John's relatives. The telegram was made public by the family, who refused to pay the sums indicated and clearly unsettled and scandalised citizens who were sensitive to anything relating to the Titanic disaster. That is awful stuff. Awful. The article goes on about the talks about the other musicians as well as. And on the next page. Okay, shipyards and politics. In the early 20th century, 80% of industrial manufacturing in Ireland was concentrated in Ulster, including major shipyards. This article talks about the Ulster Unionists, Winston Churchill, and the Home Rule for Ireland. Very political, very interesting as well. Talks about the Harland and Wolff shipyards. On the next page, everyone in the gym. Gyms on cruise ships. Usually empty when I've seen them. Several photographs of Titanic's gym exist today. In this photograph, the gym instructor, Thomas W. McCauley, demonstrates the rowing machine, while the man in the background rides the electric horse. Look comical. On board Titanic, no expense was spared to ensure that passengers had an entertaining voyage. Passengers could keep in physical shape by frequenting the onboard gym. The illustration above was used in a White Star Line publicity brochure for Olympic and sister ship Titanic. Excellent stuff. You have walkways on the decks now, so you can either walk or jog. And this one is about physical therapy. Dr. Gustav Zander was a Swedish surgeon. In the 1860s, he was one of the inventors of mechanotherapy, physical therapy involving apparatus. Unbelievable. And here we have lifts for the first class passengers. There was 3 of, operated by bellboys, I think, or whatever they were called, crew members anyway. Titanic aimed to offer its first class passengers all the conveniences which they were accustomed in daily life, for sure. That's off one of the brochures. Excellent stuff. And here we have details for the engine, the instructions. So let's get on with the build. So here we have the parts, nicely packaged as always. There we go. Yep. That's a lovely piece of metal. We can put that on the ship afterwards. Excellent stuff. Screws. And valves, apparently these little valves are delicate, so you gotta be careful with these. There we have. Okay, those two are the same. 10D, 10C, 10B, on to 10E, the 10F. Okay, we need the engine. Okay, here we have the engine, so we can start off by putting 10D in place, which goes just there. There's two pegs, both the same size, and that will go. If it is a loose fit, you can glue these in place. Well, that's quite fine, that. And then we have 10C. Does say which way it goes round. Well, the pegs, there's a large one and a small one, so it will only go in one way, even though the instructions show you which way it should go. That is going to be, nope, that's just a time to fit. And these two go on the end, so again they will only go on one way, but just make sure that that is on the inside. So that will go there like that, and will be accompanied by one of these, again small and a large peg, nicely tight fitted. And again, same on this end. Turn that round a bit and squeeze that in. These are shaped anyway to match the cylinder top. There we go. Then it's just a case of putting these valves in. Now they do go in, whoops, with the short end in the middle. So be careful with these, apparently they're very delicate and they peel out as well, to be honest. Let's get some tweezers. Excellent. That's all the detail in place. Holy jubbly. Now we can do that hull section, or keel section, I should say. Okie doke, here we have the ship. Right, this little piece goes just there like that. And then we screw it in from underneath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws. Right. We've got there. And then we'll pop that one in first. Let's tap that one in place. Just adjusted the cameras so we can get a better look at what I'm doing. Excellent. There we go. There we go, pop that out of the way. Let me just adjust that camera. There we go, that's that keel section in place. Brilliant. Does look to be a bit of a gap there, to be honest. Don't think I can move it over anymore. But I'm not too worried about that at all, because you're never going to see it anywhere. Well, that looks brilliant anyway. Fantastic stuff. Let's see, put that on that stand. There we go. So that is that for today. Excellent. Well, there we go, folks. That's it. That's issue 10. There she looks. Excellent stuff. And here we have all that detail on the engine. Looking absolutely superb. Brilliant. So that can go there. And that can go there. Excellent stuff. Well, I hope you did enjoy that. I hope you enjoyed the magazine as well, because I love these historical content that they put in these magazines. Hachette are really good at doing this with the magazine. So, but anyway, it's looking brilliant. It's looking more and more like a ship. There's the forecastle. That can pop on there now. That looks brilliant. There she is. Excellent stuff. This is going to be one to really show off. This has got to go under the telly, this, in the front room. Anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you probably in a couple of weeks' time. I'm not going to be around for the next week or so. So, may the 4th be with you. See you soon. Bye.